One of the fundamentals of democracy is to cast your vote. Tomorrow, don't blame anybody if your vote is not cast. Because quite often what we see is that people assume that they have the voter's ID in the place where they're residing. On the last day, or the day of voting, they run around like headless chickens trying to find, and often say, "Arre, mera naam nahi hai, kal tak to mera naam tha. Last time I voted, where's my name gone now? I have the voter ID card, but I don't have a vote." Voter ID card is not a kind of a document that entitles you to vote. You need to check each and every time whether your name is there in the voters list. Just go to the site nvsp.in, nvsp.in, and check and ensure. You check with our organization that is doing this. You can check with Modi Army on how to get the voter registration done. Second thing, don't assume that you are staying in a place where you don't have a voter ID, right? You have. If you have been staying for more than 6 months in a place where you are, for example, if you're in Hyderabad, but you're originally from, say, UP or Bihar or even Kolkata, you can still vote in Hyderabad, provided you submit 3-4 vital documents. What are the documents we need? One is your photograph. Second is your date of birth proof. Now, date of birth proof can range from your Aadhaar card to your PAN card, to your driving license, to your passport, anything that has your date of birth in it. Then comes the address proof. Now, how do you get the address proof? The address proof can come from a variety of sources. It can be your passport again, it can be your driving license, it cannot be your Aadhaar card, because as per Supreme Court mandated norms, the address cannot be taken from Aadhaar card. It can be a driving license, it can be a passport, it can be your bank passbook. For example, many of people whom I have seen who come from outside Hyderabad often say, "Oh, I'm staying in a rented accommodation. How do I get my, my address?" Even your rent agreement, lease agreement with the owner, that is also good enough to take your entire details. So please ensure that your voting is done in a proper manner for that. Because if you don't cast your vote, if you don't exercise your right, don't ask for your rights. That is the basic flaw here. Please understand. Don't assume that mera ek vote se kya hone wala hai. Lot of things can happen. A voting day is not meant to be a holiday. It is not meant for a short vacation. You have to stand in line. You have to vote. But before getting into that, please contact our volunteers who will be there from next week onwards. They'll be there everywhere in the IT district, in every part of the constituency, to ensure that your names are registered. In this particular link also, you will have our telephone numbers and email IDs to contact. Contact us and we will help you register as a voter. Please exercise your fundamental right. This is your right. A hard-fought battle that we won against the British is to be a democracy. And if you don't exercise your right, as I said, you have no right to complain about bad roads, leaking drainage, or even a politician who got elected wrongly. It is your mistake that you didn't vote. So get yourself registered right now. Thank you.